Nokia, the Finnish telecommunications company that once had a lion's share of the global cell phone market, now wants to compete on the basis of security. Niklas Lindroos, who heads health, safety, security and environment for mobile networks at Nokia, said in an interview with NewsPulse News. Huawei emerged in recent years seemingly from nowhere, supported by massive government subsidies, a network of research and development facilities, and a footprint in rural and developing areas around the world. Nokia and Ericsson of Sweden, once giants in the field, began to lag behind in development and competitive pricing. However, as Washington has Huawei in its crosshairs, the small European companies see an opportunity. Lindroos and Carol Mattila, Nokia's head of government relations for Finland, gave a straightforward pitch during an interview with NewsPulse News on Nokia's campus in Espoo just days earlier. If governments have a history of being spied on, or are considering using their 5G networks for anything more sensitive than consumer communications, Nokia's security should be a big selling point, despite Huawei's massive resources and lower prices. 5G will be a critical infrastructure under all the other critical infrastructure, be it finance, transport, healthcare, you know, practically everything, said Mattila. According to Lindroos, Nokia is actively involved in conversations about developing the official standards for 5G, which are expected to be completed by 2020, though Huawei has also sent representatives to participate in those discussions. Multiple international bodies are working on developing standards, including the International Telecommunications Union, a United Nations body in Geneva, the Internet Engineering Task Force, based in the US, and the Third Generation Partnership Project, which meets in different locations around the world. Time will tell whether Nokia's promises are real and make a difference in its effort to reclaim markets that Huawei has recently dominated. The competitors, along with Ericsson, are some of the only companies that manufacture the basic components, such as radios, switches, chips and routers, necessary to build up 5G networks. Ultimately, it's for the country looking to purchase 5G networks to decide, not for Nokia, said Lindroos. Different countries need to think about how they will use 5G, whether that's for commercial purposes or sensitive government networks, and consider past experiences with foreign espionage and theft, Lindroos said. Of course, he continued, there's a degree of politics as well in that decision-making. The politics are one of the reasons that many smaller European nations have declined to take a firm stance against Huawei, despite repeated urging from the Trump administration. The Nokia executives never explicitly referenced Huawei, but European officials in Northern and Eastern Europe told NewsPulse News that Donald Trump's trade war with China had to some extent skewed the conversation about 5G security and the threat posed by China. America is dropping a lot of verbal bombs, said Dennis Broders, a senior fellow at the Hague Program for Cyber Norms at Leiden University, in the Netherlands. It makes a lot of people in Europe recoil. Whereas the United States has banned Huawei outright, European national security officials suggested they recognized the potential threat, but might wait out the geopolitical storm before taking a firm stance. It seems like we have a united Europe, but we don't, said one former senior Dutch intelligence official, referring to the debate over Huawei. Germany's telecommunications regulator has refused to block Huawei. The United Kingdom has demanded source code access and technical compliance to manage the risk posed by foreign providers like Huawei. Some countries are testing partial bans, or leaving it up to the telecoms to decide. Skeptical politicians and industry experts have demanded concrete evidence that Huawei has done anything wrong. Now that might be at hand. The Dutch intelligence agency is probing whether or not Huawei created a backdoor in a major Dutch telecom firm's network, according to Dutch journalist Wiebe Motterkoek for news outlet De Volkskrant. Technical compliance is not the only factor being considered. When asked about the security threat posed by Huawei, Estonia's top cybersecurity diplomat, Heli Tiermakler, told NewsPulse News that human rights such as China's policy of confining the Uyghur religious minority in internment camps should also be considered. Huawei is not only a supply chain issue. It's a very worrying trend in China of disregarding the international rule of law and human rights. Estonia and Iceland are considered some of the freest countries when it comes to internet freedom, while China is at the other end. If we allow these governments to provide this technology, what does that mean for the future when everything will be connected? Swedish Defense Minister Peter Hultqvist in an interview on cybersecurity and 5G emphasized the importance of maintaining control over critical infrastructure. It's always important to have security around important properties, he told NewsPulse News. He did not comment specifically on the US call for a Huawei ban. Sweden is home to Huawei's other top competitor, Ericsson, the world's third largest telecom equipment company, which would also benefit from a Huawei ban in Scandinavia and elsewhere in Europe. In the Stockholm airport, advertisements for Ericsson greet passengers upon arrival. Ericsson directly competes with Nokia, although Matala and Lindroos noted the two sometimes share information about common threats facing the industry. Ericsson CEO Börje Ekholm has stressed the importance of keeping Europe, the original leader in mobility, competitive in 5G, focusing more on speed and innovation and a return to European dominance, rather than on security concerns over Huawei. Ekholm has even announced that Ericsson aims to have 5G contracts in China. For Matala, who works in government relations for Nokia, this could be the moment that security and digital sovereignty, essentially, a nation's ability to control its own communications networks, become a central concern of European governments. It is a great thing that governments have woken up to this, regardless of the motives or the timing, he told NewsPulse News. Although Nokia has 37 commercial deals for 5G, Huawei's technology, subsidized by the Chinese government, is often the most affordable and makes the best option for rural and developing regions. It may come down to the kind of security countries or localities can afford, further politicizing the issue. One industry source noted that companies may find it difficult to monetize security and freedom from foreign interference if they come at a higher price. Lindroos, who works on the security of mobile networks for Nokia, told NewsPulse News that cooperation with government bodies or three-letter agencies, hinting at the U.S. intelligence community, is sometimes useful for security. However, he remains wary of organizations that don't share information necessary for protecting consumers. When asked whether government agencies have improved in their efforts to be transparent, particularly following the leak of thousands of documents by former National Security Agency contractor Edward Snowden, both Lindroos and Matala expressed skepticism. For the private sector, the question may not be whether Huawei can be trusted despite its connections to the Chinese government, but whether any company close to government agencies can be trusted. Security agencies sometimes keep flaws in security products secret because they were thinking about how it could be utilized in an adversarial network, Lindroos said. Lindroos was also skeptical of the UK's demand that Huawei share its source code with British officials for security reviews, not because Huawei could evade detection, as several other European officials noted, but because the UK could take advantage of that opportunity too. Research for this article was made possible with the support of the Heinrich Böll Foundation North America.